prowl the shore. Get them all! What is this thing?
Prepare to fire! Fire!
Watch out! Those tentacles are powerful!
Excellent! They're digging a way in!
He has opened the gate!
I knew he was good for something! Stand back! It shall be a dwarf who first enters Moria! The rumors are true. Balin has failed. My people have failed.
This fight took place decades ago. Their bodies returned to dust.
These great dwarf lords stood here for thousands of years, Elf. And this abomination took place before them. I do not find that amusing. Some small measure of their great power remains hidden here. I can feel it.
Let me help you reclaim it. For your people.
This dwarf who joins your company heralds. Seven rings of power were given to the dwarf lords, great miners and craftsmen of the mountain halls. But they were deceived by the Dark Lord Sauron. And in time, their kingdoms fell into ruin. But the dwarves hold many secrets, and few are graced to share their language. The secret runes of their ancient kings remain lost in these empty halls. It is your secret to find, my friend. Now, brave friend, your band must enter a charnel house, for here lie the bodies of many dwarven generations. Many were slaughtered by invading orcs that bred and multiplied in Moria's darkness. Now they rule the vast halls and spread through the corridors and mines. But they do not rule Moria. That is the province of another, more powerful being. Tread carefully in the darkness, for you enter a world of enemies. Move swiftly, for if you do not, they shall find you.
Thank you.
Very good. You have now entered the long dark of Moria. Moria is a lost civilization that spans many ages. And in the deep places of this world, foul terrors still dwell, filled with wrath and malice. I expect you found the landscape changed since we recently passed through. That was the work of the Watcher in the water. For what good are words of opening, or enchanted doors for that matter, against such ancient powers? Saruman admires the war, the terrible creation that mocks the wolf. To spread terror, he unleashed them upon the lands surrounding Isengard. They are fast and powerful creatures, able to bring down a horse and rider. Few can withstand their attack. There is evidence they invaded Moria, but I avoided their dens. I hope we were as fortunate.
hardest to kill.
I might resent that remark, but I think you're right.
What have you got there?
It would appear we have discovered the last delving of the dwarves, the great Mithril pit.
And that mine would likely lead us to the other side of the mountain, would it not?
So what do we wait for? Let us follow it!
I see you found your way deep into Moria's Mithril mines. For that was the true wealth of this realm. Hard as dragon scales, but light as a feather. It has no rival in times of war. Some seek it unto death. Some are given it freely. The lands you passed through were built around its trade. Now none dare seek it in these dark halls. Do not fear as you wander Moria's mazes, for powerful beings such as I are here to aid you. For many long years I have played the role of a grey wanderer across the lands of Middle-earth. Another, the white wizard Saruman, calls himself the leader of our order. But Saruman chose to see afar, to see all, and in his greed he became enslaved. We have had, you see, a falling out. And thus his servants have forced our party to skirt Saruman's domain. For he hopes that within Moria I shall fall to a greater power than even he possesses. These wretched orcs are trapped within these halls. They hide from the sun, but more do they fear their new master. They awaken him in times of great need, yet always fall victim to his terrible wrath. Found our campsite. That is very good indeed. You have also found Boromir, for he has traveled with us since Rivendell. Have you considered, Berethor, precisely why you were compelled to seek him? Many that live deserve death, and some that die deserve life. Do not be too eager to deal out death and judgment. Even the very wise cannot see all ends.
Thank you.
breed knows only fear and domination. It does not matter their size. Remember this lesson well, for there are much more powerful orcs upon your road. And some I hope you never encounter.
Thank you.
Long have I walked the forgotten paths of Middle-earth, and oft I studied the treasury of their past. Thousands of years ago, elves fought in a last alliance with men, overthrowing the evil of Sauron. But their animosity towards dwarves extends further back in time. None speak of deeds that divided them, but ancient distrust still burns in the hearts of both races.
Have you heard nothing Lord Elrond has said? The ring must be destroyed.
And I suppose you think you're the one to do it.
So much,
no, I trust an elf.
You witness a rare thing, Gondorian. Elf and dwarf united in uneasy fellowship. But as you travel these lands, your small company faces the same old hatreds. Unite them, for the remaining treasures of Moria will not be surrendered without a fight. graced, my friend, for the Lady of the Light guards and guides you. The elves channel the powers of fire, air, earth, and water, for they are the firstborn. Should you survive, Moria, it is likely you will see their realm, despite the evil you carry with you. For many long ages has the Lady Galadriel fought the Shadow, but it has not claimed her. Go now and finish your task. They await you beneath the trees.
Yeah. What do we have here?
Can't you tell by the wrapping of the shaft? It's the last axe ever forged in Moria. A respected ranger.
I'm sorry, my friend. I meant no disrespect.
As you have learned, my friend, dwarves are formidable tunnel fighters. Now, as you behold their shattered armories, you glimpse weapons wielded long in the defense of Moria. Tools and devices of war, large and small, were forged here. Some have been lost, some recently found, but the greatest of all still remains hidden. Not only the dwarves have inhabited these mountains, for this huge range divides Middle-earth east from west. Long ago, on the eastern slopes, orcs slew Isildur, the king of Gondor, and have since infested these crags. Other creatures, such as Gollum, also sought refuge here. Now that the northern passes are sealed, scant few inhabit this ghostly realm, save for goblins.
Thank you.